So this is Poornachandra Devi. So in the part one of lecture three, we discussed about definition of semiconductors and classification of semiconductors. Based on impurity added to it. So the semiconductors mainly includes two types, that is intrinsic semiconductors and extrinsic semiconductors. In intrinsic semiconductor, the impurity is since impurity is not added to the semiconductor, they are known as intrinsic semiconductors. Okay, so sometimes intrinsic semiconductors, they are also called as pure semiconductor. Why? Because the semiconductor doesn't have any impurity added to it. So that's why they are also called as pure semiconductors. Sometimes we are also calling intrinsic semiconductors as I-type semiconductors. Okay. Suppose we are adding impurity to the semiconductor, then the semiconductor becomes extrinsic semiconductor. Okay. So in extrinsic semiconductors, again we are having classification that is based on the type of impurity added to it. So we can add two types of impurities. Before going to adding impurities to the semiconductors, so the best examples for the intrinsic semiconductors are like silicon and germanium. So since it consists of silicon and germanium, they are having four valence electrons each. Okay, so that's why we can add one excess electron. We can add two types of impurities to the intrinsic semiconductors. Okay, so one is pentavalent impurity, the other one is trivalent impurity. If the added impurity is pentavalent impurity, we can call it as n-type semiconductor. If the added impurity is trivalent impurity, we can call it as p-type semiconductor. Okay, so in the part one of lecture three, we clearly explained about the types of impurities added. The pentavalent impurity example is phosphorus, the trivalent impurity example is boron. Okay, so the pentavalent impurity consists of five valence electrons, the trivalent impurity consists of three valence electrons. Okay, so next we clearly explained about n-type semiconductors. Okay, so if the added impurity is pentavalent impurity, we can call it as n-type semiconductors. Okay, in n-type semiconductors, the dominant concentration is due to electrons. So that's why we can say electrons concentration dominates whole concentration in n-type semiconductors. Okay, so we also looked at the conductivity of one more point, that is the conductivity of extrinsic semiconductors is more compared to the conductivity of the intrinsic semiconductors. That's why we prefer extrinsic semiconductors to manufacture the electronic components like diodes, transistors, etc. Okay, so we also saw in n-type semiconductors the covalent bonding. So the phosphorus atom is in the middle. It is surrounded by silicon atoms. So the four valence electrons present in silicon atom, they are participating covalent bonding with the four valence electrons present in the phosphorus atom. Okay, so since phosphorus is having one extra electron which is not participating in covalent bonding, why? Because the silicon consists of only four valence electrons. So the excess electrons present in phosphorus atom, it is free electron. Okay, means each phosphorus atom which it donates one free electron. Likewise, if you add a small impurity to the small pentavalent impurity, or you can say small phosphorus, pentavalent impurity, the example is phosphorus. If you add small amount of impurity to the intrinsic semiconductor, which is a pentavalent impurity, it produces millions of free electrons. Okay, so that's why we can say the electrons concentration dominates whole concentration in n-type semiconductors. So from this we can say one more point, like the majority charge carriers in n-type semiconductor are electrons. The minority charge carriers are like holes. Okay, so next we saw, conduction process in n-type semiconductors. So if you apply some electric field, the electrons present in n-type semiconductor, they are attracted towards positive terminal of applied voltage or applied electric field. The holes present in n-type semiconductor, they are attracted towards negative terminal of the applied voltage or applied electric field. Okay, so from this next piece, current density in n-type semiconductors. So to get the current density in n-type semiconductors, we use current density in semiconductors, that is J is equal to sigma E, where sigma is equal to nq mu n plus pq mu b into whole into E. Okay, for n-type semiconductor, already we know that is donor concentration ND, which is electron concentration dominates, which is greater than, far greater than P, that is hole concentration. So that's why we can neglect term, that is PQ mu P into E. Okay, why? Because ND is far greater than P. So then current density in n-type semiconductor JN becomes approximately equal to ND Q mu N into E, capital ND. Capital ND is donor concentration, Q is the charge of the electrons. Mu N is the mobility of electrons, E is the applied electric field. That's about n-type semiconductors. Next, now we'll see in detail about p-type semiconductors. When the added impurity is trivalent impurity, then we can call it as p-type semiconductor. So suppose we are adding trivalent impurity to the intrinsic or pure semiconductor, then the semiconductor becomes a p-type semiconductor. Okay, so already we know the trivalent impurities, the examples are like phosphorus, arsenic and antimony, etc. So all these are are called as it is not donor impurity, it is acceptor impurity. Sorry, there is a mistake in this slide, correct it. Okay, why? Because there is some vacant space which is ready to occupy with electron. That's why the impurity is called as acceptor impurity. So the boron atom has three valence electrons, and the intrinsic semiconductor, that is silicon or germanium, consists of four valence electrons. Okay, so the three valence electrons in the boron atom, they are in covalent bonding with the three valence electrons in the silicon atom. Okay, since silicon is having if you see boron atom, it consists of only three valence electrons. These three valence electrons, they are in covalent bonding with the three electrons present in the silicon. There is one vacant space which is known as hole. Okay, so the hole which is ready to occupy the electron. So that's why it is ready to accept the electron. That's why the trivalent impurity, it is nothing but acceptor impurity. Okay, if it is pentavalent impurity, that is donor impurity. So you can see the covalent bonding in p-type semiconductors clearly. So center atom is boron, it is surrounded by silicon atoms. So already I told you boron consists of three valence electrons in its valence shell. That's why the impurity, the boron impurity, is nothing but trivalent impurity. Okay, so the three electrons present in boron, they are in covalent bonding with the three electrons in the silicon atom. Okay, so in boron, in valence shell, there is one vacant space, that is ready to accept electron, which is the empty space is nothing but hole. Okay, since it is ready to accept electron, the impurity is known as acceptor impurity. Okay, so this is about, so if you see for n-type semiconductor, the center one is phosphorus. It is surrounded by silicon, as you can say, no need to say, strictly silicon. You can also put germanium as example, p-type or n-type semiconductor. Okay, so but impurity, there it is phosphorus. Here the impurity is boron. You can consider pentavalent impurities for n-type semiconductor, or other trivalent impurities for p-type semiconductor. So there one excess electron, that's why that is the phosphorus is donor impurity. Here it is ready to occupy one electron, that's why ready to accept or occupy. Okay, that's why it is known as acceptor impurity. Okay, so this is about covalent bonding present in p-type semiconductors. So next we will see, already I explained in the, three electrons, they are participating in covalent bond. The fourth covalent bond, only silicon atom contributes one valence electron, while the boron atom has no valence electron to contribute. Why? Because it is having only three valence electrons. Thus, the fourth covalent bond is incomplete with shortage of one electron. Why? Because, I explained in the above point itself, the boron has only three valence electrons. So the missing electron or the vacant space is nothing but a hole. Okay, so likewise, one boron atom contributes one hole. Likewise, each boron atom accept one electron to fill the hole. Okay, so all the trivalent impurities are called acceptors. So I told you already about pentavalent impurities. All the pentavalent impurities are called donors. Likewise, all the trivalent impurities are called acceptors. Why? Because there the impurity is donating one free electron. Here the impurity is ready to accept one electron, which consists of one free space or hole. So that's why these are called as acceptors. Their trivalent impurities are, pentavalent impurities are called as donors. So there we also saw, small addition of impurity to the, semiconductor, which produces, there if it is pentavalent impurity, that produces the millions of electrons. So similarly here, if you see for p-type semiconductor, a small addition of impurity, the impurity may be, impurity is trivalent impurity, here it is example boron, so which provides millions of holes. There in n-type, the small addition of impurity, that is phosphorus, provides millions of electrons. Okay. So there in in n-type semiconductor, the dominant concentration is electron concentration. Here the dominant concentration is holes concentration. Okay. So there already we saw conduction process in n-type semiconductor. Now we'll see conduction process in p-type semiconductors. Here also if you see, so if you apply some external electric field or external voltage, so the electrons present in p-type semiconductor, okay, they are very less in number, so they attract towards positive polarity of the applied electric field. So the holes present in p-type semiconductor, they are attracted towards negative polarity of the applied electric field or applied voltage. So you can see clearly in p-type material, electrons and holes. So holes are indicated with the white circle, small white circle. The electrons are indicated with some color, that is circle with some color. And moreover, the electrons are moving towards left, that is they are attracted towards positive polarity of the applied electric field or applied voltage. So if you see the holes present in p-type, there you can clearly see they move towards right side and they are attracted towards negative polarity of the applied voltage or applied electric field. So already I told you, like charges repels with each other and opposite charges attracts with each other. Okay, so if you see when the voltage is applied applied to the p-type semiconductor, so already I explained this in the last slide itself, the holes attracted towards negative terminal, whereas electrons move towards positive terminal of the applied voltage or applied electric field. Okay, so in if you see in n-type semiconductor, the electron concentration is very high compared to the holes concentration. But when it comes to p-type semiconductor, the hole concentration is very high compared to the electrons concentration. Okay. In n-type semiconductor, the majority charge carriers are electrons, whereas in p-type semiconductor, the majority charge carriers are holes. Okay. Next point, in n-type semiconductors, the minority charge carriers are electrons, But in p-type semiconductors, the minority charge carriers are holes. Why? Because in n-type, the dominant concentration is electrons concentration, whereas in p-type, the dominant concentration is holes concentration. The dominance of charge carriers depends on the type of impurities added to the semiconductor, or you can say intrinsic semiconductor. Okay, so if you consider in n-type semiconductor, the conduction is mainly because of electrons, whereas in p-type semiconductor, the conduction is mainly because of holes. Why? Because here in p-type holes dominates, whereas in n-type electrons dominates. Okay, so already we saw current density n-type semiconductors. So in n-type semiconductors, the donor concentration, that is electron concentration, which is far greater than hole concentration. When it comes to p-type semiconductors, the acceptor concentration, it is Na, which is far greater than electron concentration. Okay, why? Because the added impurity is trivalent impurity, which consists of only three valence electrons. So it consists of one vacant space which is ready to accept electron. So that's why here the dom, it is known as acceptor concentration in A. There it is ready to donate electron when you add pentavalent impurity. That's why the concentration is known as donor concentration. Okay, to arrive at current density in p-type semiconductors, again we use the same, starts from current density in conductors, that is J is equal to I by A. So from there, by using current equation and drift velocity equation and time to travel electron from one end to the other end, so by using all those things, we arrived at J is equal to sigma E, where sigma is the conductivity, E is the applied electric field electric field applied to the conductor or semiconductor. Okay, so where sigma is if it is only conductor, the sigma is equal to nq mu n. Why? Because conductor doesn't have any holes. Okay, suppose if it is semiconductor, which consists of both holes and electrons, that's why conductivity sigma is equal to nq mu n plus pq mu p, where n is the electron concentration, small n and small p. Small n is the electron concentration, q is the charge of the electron and charge of the hole. Mu n is the mobility of electrons, and mu p is the mobility of holes, and j is equal to sigma e, e is the applied electric field, or electric field applied to the semiconductor. Okay, so by using the same relation, j is equal to nq mu n plus pq mu p into e. So here if you see the acceptor concentration, which is nothing but holes concentration, which is far greater than electron concentration. That's why the term present in that is nq mu n into e, which is negligible compared to the pq mu p. Why? Because Na is far greater than small n. Na is the acceptor concentration. So now J and the current density in p-type semiconductors, that is indicated with J suffix small p, which is equal to, in place of P, we can put Na, that is acceptor concentration, Na into Q into mu P into E, JP, that is current density in p-type semiconductors. Okay, so Na is acceptor concentration, Q is the charge of the holes, mu P is the mobility of holes, JP is the current density in p-type semiconductors. Okay, suppose if you see for n-type semiconductor, that is JN is equal to approximately equal to ndq mu n into e. There nd is the donor concentration. So by nd, dominates holes concentration, nd is far greater than p. Here na is far greater than n. So this is about p-type semiconductors, the definition and covalent bonding in p-type semiconductors, at the end conduction in p-type semiconductor, and current density in p-type semiconductors. So next we will see one figure that is related to energy band diagram of n-type and p-type semiconductors. Already you know the energy band diagram of any material which includes I mean, valency band, conduction band, and forbidden gap are energy band gap. Okay, so if you see for n-type semiconductors, the energy band diagram, the first one that is, which is present on the left side of the figure. So we are having donor level, that is ED. So the acceptor level EA. So the energy band gap, gap between two bands, that is conduction band and valency band, is nothing but forbidden gap or energy band gap. If you see donor level, which is very close to the conduction band, why? Because so the donor level consists of the electrons donated by the added impurity. So suppose if you add a small amount of impurity which donates millions of electrons, okay? So that since they are all free electrons, they are very close to the conduction band. Why? Because in general conduction band consists of free electrons. Suppose if you see for p-type semiconductors, the acceptor level, so the acceptor level is very close to the valency band. Why? Because the added impurity is trivalent impurity, which consists of one vacant space which is ready to accept electron. That's why with the small addition of impurity to the intrinsic semiconductor, which is the trivalent impurity, which contributes millions of free holes, they are very much close to the valency band. Okay, suppose if you want to move some more electrons present in valency band to the conduction band, for that what you have to do means you have to increase the temperature, or you have to apply some thermal energy to the semiconductor or n-type semiconductor. When you apply that, what happens, the electrons present in valency band, they start moving to conduction band. That type of transition is known as band to band transition. Okay, so suppose if you increase temperature more and more, the electron concentration at some point of time, the electron concentration dominates holes concentration. Okay, so what happens, sometimes the semiconductor may becomes insulator. Okay, so this is not at all required for you. As an extra information, I explained about band to band transition. Okay, so that's about extrinsic semiconductors and the classification of extrinsic semiconductors. So that is n-type semiconductor, and other one is p-type semiconductor. So in lecture 3, that is we started with the definition of semiconductor, then slowly classification of semiconductor based on the impurity added to it. Okay, if the impurity is not added, then we can say that is intrinsic semiconductor. If the impurity is added, we can call it as extrinsic semiconductor. Okay, then in the extrinsic semiconductor, based on the type of impurity, that is whether it is trivalent or pentavalent, pentavalent. If it is trivalent impurity, it is classified as n-type semiconductor. If it is pentavalent impurity, it is classified as p-type semiconductor. Okay, so we clearly explained about p-type and n-type. In n-type, the dominant concentration is because of electrons. In p-type, the dominant concentration is holes concentration. In n-type, the majority charge carriers are electrons. In p-type, the majority charge carriers are holes. In n-type, the minority charge carriers are holes. In p-type, the minority charge carriers are electrons. In n-type, the conduction is due to electrons. In p-type, the conduction is due to holes. Okay. If you see in n-type, the added impurity is pentavalent impurity. In p-type, the added impurity is trivalent impurity. Okay, so in n-type, n-type semiconductor, the added impurity is donor impurity. Why? Because it is ready to donate free electron. In p-type semiconductor, the added impurity is acceptor impurity. Why? Because it is ready to accept the electrons. Okay, the small amount of impurity added to I mean, the semiconductor, that is pentavalent impurity, which contributes millions of electrons. When it comes to p-type, the small amount of added impurity contributes millions of holes. Okay, so I mean, when it comes to conduction process, so I mean, you can say the current density in n-type semiconductor, that is Jn, is equal to ndq mu n into e, where nd is the donor concentration, mu is the mobility of electrons, q is the charge of electron, e is the applied electric field applied to the n-type semiconductor, or you can say simply conductor, semiconductor. Okay, when it comes to p-type semiconductors, the current density is jp is equal approximately equal to na, small I mean capital na, q mu p into e. Capital Na is the acceptor concentration, Q is the charge, which is 1.6 into 10 power minus 19. Mu P is the mobility of holes, E is the electric field applied to the P-type semiconductor. Okay, this is about lecture 3, that is extrinsic semiconductors, P-type semiconductor and N-type semiconductor. Okay. In the next lecture, that is lecture 4, we will cover about that is the drift current, diffusion current. At the end, we will see formation of p-n junction. Okay, so thank you very much.